all gold.
I'm going to be showcasing some shoes on probably the most eagerly awaited show on London Fashion Week. It's been such a long time since I've done wedges that it's actually given me the hormones with you. Because they're on beautiful models, they're sexy. After a week of working 14 hours a day, all the models like them.
Which means they'll probably run away with them. Did want to desperately wanted to do it, didn't we?
Oh yeah.
So we didn't even charge them cost. Oh,
thank you, Terry.
Hello, mate. How are you?
Thanks so much.
Despite all their hard work and long hours, Liz and Terry seem reluctant to step into the limelight.
Have you seen Sadie and Jemima?
No, but it's so difficult of this. They're probably hidden away. No, get me out of here. I've had enough.
That's Sadie Foss with the short little hair.
She's the one in
the middle.
We've got to get the shoes back now. That's going to be an interesting one.
It's great, you know, meeting people that have been there, and like I'm listening to all this 70s, 80s, you know, rock music, and then you kind of blend in. It's a fusion. And that's what's so fantastic about fashion.
Because they do, I mean, it's what happens. The catwalk shows, they just all walk with the shoes. So we'll see.
And I'm stealing a pair right now. They're going in my handbag.
But there you go.
I'm going to go and have a look. I like the green, I think.
I have no idea whether it's going to be worth it or not. I think it will.
It will be definitely worth it.
Okay, yeah, let's be positive.
Bloody shoes stole it, of course.
I couldn't steal them.
So just how much publicity did they get from the show?
Nothing.
Absolutely sweet.
Sweet
FA. Sweet FA, Fanny Adams. We saw them on television the next morning, which was great, they looked fine. But in any of the shots I've seen so far in the press, they've all been cropped. It's a bit of a bummer when you're a cobbler.
The problem they've got is they can't tell their readers where to get them.
A shop is... Yeah, it's very key to it all. It's very key to it all.
And we're beginning to realise that more and more, actually, aren't we?
Yeah.
A shop will need financial backing. Another friend, Marianne, wants to introduce them to someone who just might help.
Yeah, it's brilliant, actually. It's Mr. Dave West. Yeah, he's going to be there. He's got those EastEnders warehouses over in France where everyone goes on the kind of booze cruise type idea. Everyone goes over there and gets their alcohol and cigarettes and stuff like that.
Unfortunately, we're just going off to another do.
Uh-huh.
So I might creep back here later.
Oh, okay. We've got a feeling it's probably not Islington, funnily enough. We've got a feeling it might be in Knightsbridge, Bond Street or somewhere like that. Marianne's been talking to all sorts of press people and they're like, yeah, but where did the shoes get sold? If you can't actually get them anywhere apart from here, it's not really here. Yes, what you do is you go down to their lovely studio under Kingsland Road. Be sure you go to the toilet before you arrive.
We're moving a bit. Terry de Havilland. D, H-A.
Because I have got a feeling we're on our way now. I've got a feeling we're just about to crack it. After all these years.
Before leaving, Dave West tells Marianne he's interested in financing a shop for Terry in Knightsbridge.
I can't really take it in. I've got to hear it from the man, of course. Yeah, I can't wait to go and show up. I'll make some shoes to die for. I mean, I will make shoes to die for.
A month later, and still no news from Mr. West.
He's been doing an awful lot of work on whatever it is he does an awful lot of work on. There's all sorts of things. He's got lots of fingers in pies. There's no way we're going to pester a man like that anyway. So that just kind of went quiet, basically. Once upon a time, there lived a shoemaker and his wife. The man was a good shoemaker and he worked hard. Yet he and his wife were very poor. As time went on, they grew poorer and poorer. As they were going upstairs to bed that night, the shoemaker spoke sadly to his wife. I have used my last piece of leather, he said. I have cut out one pair of shoes. Tomorrow I will sew them. When they are sold, I do not know what will become of us. Because all of a sudden it started to sound a little bit familiar. What actually happens throughout the story is there's these two little elves that come in late at night to make the shoes, and they're absolutely exquisite. So it ends up that his tiny little shop becomes actually really popular because he's suddenly got a reputation of making really beautiful, unusual, fabulously made shoes. And they were rich and happy for the rest of their lives. So yeah, maybe that'll be us. It's almost like our little shop window could be.
Terry's shoes for the Frost French show did attract attention after all. High Street chain Office are interested in them for their upmarket boutique Postmistress. But Office have tried to work with Terry once before. 2 years ago, he took some samples of his 1990s work to show them.
When he actually came to show us the shoes, they were quite different from what we expected. Not quite the Terry de Havilland signature stuff that we were expecting to see.
Yeah, because what they saw the last time round, it was all the really pretty, organza-y, cutesy stuff, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was very nice.
I mean, it was very nice, but it wasn't necessarily that representative of Terry de Havilland, I'd say.
Because they were made in the UK, they were very handmade, a little bit...
Knife and fork,
yeah. Didn't kind of look worth what we would have to sell them for, which was around £300.
Yeah, we got a little bit upset, but you can't take things like that too personally. It's just kind of like, oh, well, never mind, let's move on and see where else we go.
And then that's it. We didn't hear from them again, so we kind of fell by the wayside, really.
If I had to do my how to put Terry back on the map speech, the first thing I would do was make certain he was linked up with a factory in Italy or Spain.
Samples of Terry's new designs for the Frost French show have arrived.
Yeah, that's great.
They're fantastic.
Hey, dusty pink suede.
Yeah.
Can I just say
that I back dusty pink suede.
Almost edible, isn't it? You can put it in the ice cream fountain. It's edible. The colours in that, beautiful. I mean, you cannot do those cheaply. You just can't make them.
That's an expensive shoe to make. So you've got to have somebody who really, really believes in this to get it done. He's one of those names which is very, very British and eccentric, and it's kind of what we wanted Postmistress
That's
to be
we
all about.
That, yeah. We'd love to meet Terry, and we'd love to sit there with whatever he wants to make and then see what comes out of the bag. Not promising anything, but, you know, we'll have a go.
You nearly didn't make it this morning.
I nearly didn't make it for the rest of my life this morning. I thought I was going to stay in bed forever until somebody found me.
It's called a wobbly morning.
And I just woke up with an absolute black hole of depression this morning just because life is so up and down at the moment.
Hello, how are you? I see you.
You're right, this is smart today.
And I just couldn't function. I just woke up and I was like, I can't go. I'm sorry, Terry, you have to go on your own. Well, I did have a marvellous cathartic moment when I got a big box full of cat biscuits. And I was filling the bowl with cat biscuits and I suddenly thought, I know what I'm going to do. And I just threw all the cat biscuits all around the kitchen. Thank goodness it was the cat biscuits and not a bottle of oil, otherwise we'd have had to start decorating again. So once I'd done that and had a bit of a scream, I felt fine. And Terry and I sat down, looked at each other and went, but get our suits on then, come on.
Last time I saw you, you were wearing a silver Lurex suit.
Oh, you're passing me up.
He was like, I'm bloody 65, what's the point in doing anything? I should be like retiring now, not carrying on. Or starting again. So yeah, we had one of those moments.
I brought my latest baby to show you.
She's going everywhere at the moment.
Yeah.
On tour.
She does go on tour with us, yeah.
What we think you should do is you should make your bespoke at the top end, but we still think it should be made outside of England. It should be made in a little factory in Spain. To make it out of the grade that you want and does your